We're gonna make a cheese souffle.
Hello everyone, so today we're gonna make a cheese souffle. So you can use any kind of cheese you like. If you have some leftover cheese in your back fridge, you can use it. So it's pretty cool. So, but today, we're gonna make it with some very good quality Gruyère, which is similar as Comté, to be honest. It's really nutty and it has a very good taste. So, I'm gonna use that. So basically, to start with, we need to warm up some milk. So this is to make this kind of size. So it's like 25 centimeters by 20, something like that. Yeah. So it's good. It's for 4 people, or 6 if you're not too much hungry. For me, it'd be just for myself. Because it's so delicious. So, we're gonna start. I got my little recipe written down. So 450 milk to warm up on the side. So we're gonna start to do kind of béchamel. Now, a bit more milk. 450, yeah. So this is whole milk, always the best. That we're gonna warm that up. Yeah. Okay. In this one, we're gonna do our butter and the flour. Where's my butter? Yoo-hoo! I lost my butter. There it is. Okay. So we're gonna use 50 grams of butter. Yeah, it was 47, so I just put a little there. So this, we can heat it up. I lost my handle, by the way. See, it was here, fall off. And some flour. So flour. I'm gonna do it in that cup. We need 50 grams as well of flour. Spoon. Doesn't look much compared to the amount of milk, but it's enough. So 50 grams, yeah. Ready on the side. I'm gonna put a whisk in there. So once the butter is melted, you're gonna come over and you'll have a look. So we're gonna grate the cheese. I'm just gonna put my milk back in the fridge. Yeah. Okay. So the recipe says 160 grams of cheese. Here it is 200. Let's go for that. More cheesy, better it is. So just remove the crust there. So if you have a leftover piece of blue cheese, a bit of camembert, a bit of, just make it up to 200, yeah? I'm gonna grate it. So it can melt nicely, yeah? It's incredible. This is a really good one. I found it the other day in a shop. It's really nice. Usually Gruyère is ordinary, you know, Gruyère is Gruyère. But this one is really good. Okay. Oh my god. The milk goes over. Look! Yeah. It's okay. There's nothing to compare my kitchen and this one. Okay. Oh, that's it. Now the recipe is wrong. You took it. Spit it. Give it to me back. Okay, so that's ready. That's cool. Please come over. Okay, so the butter is melted. Now we're gonna put the flour. So it's called a roux. Now we're gonna cook it until it has a nice nutty golden color. The milk is warm. I took it out. It just went all over the place, but I just lost a little drop, so it doesn't matter. So it's like a bechamel, more or less. I love that smell. Flour and butter. Okay, then. Now your butter and flour has cooked well. It has a nice and golden color. A nice and smelly taste. I'm gonna put the warm milk a little bit at a time. So that's gonna go thick straight away. A little bit more. A little bit more. It goes thick very quickly. Look. Okay. And everything. Make sure it's well, nice and smooth. We're gonna reduce the heat. This is like a bechamel, yeah, for now. Okay, that's it. Okay, we're gonna put the cheese. So 200 gram here we have. The recipe says 160, but we love cheese, aren't we? So we're all melting down nicely here. Okay, then we're gonna put 3 yolks. The yolks will help the souffle to hold, yeah, together. I'm gonna keep the white to do the egg white after. Oh no, it's cracked. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna scoop it up. You know why it cracked like that? It's my mistake. Shake it, shake the eggs, and then it split up much easier. See, hop. Three yolks, yeah, that's it. So the cheese is melting now. Put the yolks. Mix it through. And then, just for a little kick, some French mustard, just to lift up all the flavors, yeah? Little, like that, yeah? Not too much, otherwise, will kill the flavor. But this will give a nice kick. Okay, so this is done. Now we're gonna whip our egg white. Actually, how are we gonna do that? Now this is quite hot. That's okay. Gonna leave it in the pan and we're gonna whip our egg white in there. All right, so we have 7 egg white. I'm gonna take this one from my wife. I don't know how it works really. I think you push it hard. That's done. Sorry, wrong one. Okay, are you ready? Okay, that works. This is some butter, melted butter, just to glaze my dish where I'm gonna put my souffle mix. Just all around, yeah. And some breadcrumbs. So the breadcrumbs is gonna create a little shell, quite interesting. Or if you want, you could put a short crust pastry and par baked it. And then you put the souffle mix in, so it makes like a souffle tart. Voilà, it's everywhere, yeah? I will create a little crusty. So, let's do our egg white, shall we? Now we're ready with this. The oven is on, hot, 170. So we can just crack on, yeah? I hope I don't missing anything. No. Oh yes, I forgot. Little bit of lemon juice. Like that. Oh, this is terrible. I wish I could have my kitchenette here. Interesting. See, you're stuck, you can't do anything else now. You really have to whip your egg whites. Long time I haven't used something like that. It's fun. Okay, I think that's it. To the soft peak, yeah? This is a soft peak. Soft peak consistency, yeah? This is cool. Okay? So, our mixture stayed in a pan. Obviously, it's still quite warm, yeah? We're gonna just try the seasoning. I think it's okay, maybe a bit of black pepper. A bit of nutmeg, could be interesting. Salt, I'm scared because the cheese is quite salty. Just just to say that we've put some, because hey, this is quite bland, it's just no salt. So, okay, so now, spoon. Just a little bit like that, just to loose up everything, yeah? So we loose. Okay. And now, we're gonna put the rest, but we're gonna mix it very gently. This we're gonna mix it gently here. Yeah? We're gonna carry on with a spatula. And we're just gonna fold it in, yeah. Don't over mix it because you lose all your air. So very gently, yeah. Then we're gonna pour it into our dish. Well, the dish looks a bit small actually. There we go. Just. And then on top, I'm gonna top it up with a bit of cheesy again. Let's put some Parmigiano. That's gonna create a little cheesy crust. Pretty cool. And maybe a little bit more of this one. The same Gruyère that is inside. Maybe on a thin grating this time, a bit thinner. I think that's lovely, like that. Bang it in the oven until it's cooked. We're gonna put a timer. We're gonna put 12 minutes and let's see what happens. Okay, so the souffle is ready. It's been 26 minutes in total in the oven. It's beautiful. It smells divine. So, let's plate it up, shall we? You're gonna hear the crack of the crust. First, I'm just gonna do a little dressing, a little bit of lemon juice, salt, pepper, oil. Mixy. Just to look a bit more presentable. So this, with a salad, it's ideal. Stay here, you. Okay. Listen. Oh. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Oh, it's a big cloud of goodness. Look at that. It's beautiful. One more scoopy. Ah, it's fantastic. So there we go, guys. If you like our recipe, please subscribe to know what's come next, and we'll see you soon.
Fantastic.
Okay, John, what do you think of my souffle?
Well, it's out of this world. It's the cheese is, and the softness and the airiness, it's absolutely beautiful. And I haven't got a microphone on, so you probably won't hear me.
Yes, yes, we can hear you.
It's absolutely beautiful. But
it's like a cloud,
it's,
yeah?
It's like a cloud. It's so, it's just crunchy. And,
it's a cheesy paradise.
It's beautiful.
We say that's all.
That's all.